Hello everyone, my name is Nadia Salgado Herrera, and thanks to Opal RT Technologies for the invitation to the 12th Conference on Real-Time Simulation. I am an associate research at the Instituto de Energías Renovables de la Universidad Nacional Autónoma de México. My research area is power electronics, and my objective within IERUNAM is to carry out the energy conditioning for the integration of renewable sources in electrical networks. In this presentation, I will talk about real-time validation of wind energy conversion systems under wind speed conditions in Tamaulipas, Mexico. The content includes a visualization of the current project in Hardware in the Loop by Wind Group of IERUNAM, the introduction the wind speed condition in Tamaulipas, Mexico, the modeling of wind energy conversion systems, the WEX simulation and MATLAB Simulink, the WEX validation in Opal RT Technologies, the analysis of the simulation results in Opal RT Technologies, the experimental advances, and finally the conclusions. In our research area, the wind group has the instruments, device, and infrastructure required in the design and implementation of wind energy generation. That is, in the laboratory, we are generating the necessary studies for the proper operation of this. Begins identifying the wind resource in geographical areas of Mexico. The technology designs of the WEX integration delivering a high quality energy in both interconnected into the grid or in isolated mode. Into the area of WEX, the main research field is the power electronics, due to that the power converting designs, which include the closed loop voltage and current control, modulation schemes, and the corresponding topologies according to the wind turbine. In order to meet global objectives related to climate, air quality, indiscriminate and low-cost access to electrical power, the deployment of renewable energy needs the 3D operation scheme, decarbonization, distribution and digitalization. The use of wind generation provides clean energy from the point of view that the fossil fuels are not used to generate electricity. In Mexico, there are several areas with high wind speeds, which can be used for wind generation. As an example, at the end of 2018, a production of 4,875 megawatts was obtained, the majority of which come from Oaxaca. This state has the largest installed wind generation capacity in Mexico, followed by Tamaulipas. I like to think that we can continue using this characterization in order to evolve the national electrical system. One challenge in the electrical grid operation is the interconnection of wind generation, because it is considered an intermittent source. However, one solution is the creation of distributed renewable energy access, which are systems based on renewable source that can generate and distribute energy independently of a centralized electrical grid, where the principal objective is the electricity supply production in rural or isolated areas, in which the generation is not possible, due to that, the high cost or damage to ecosystems by the electrical grid wirings. This panorama is called distributed generation, where users adopt the figure of cell suppliers instead of consumers. In the digitalization, the electrical grid variables such as voltage, power, frequency are converted into machine language in order to have a useful database in the forecasting of generation and demand, determining the electrical grid correct operation. In this scenario, well, as we know, Opal RT offers a complete real-time digital simulation solution for wind power conversion systems, providing scalability, flexibility, and reliability to examine the future devices or system integration involved in power grid innovation at all electrical levels. This research selects the state of Tamaulipas. It ranks the second place in Mexico for wind power generation, with installed capacity of 1,163 megawatts in 2019. The select region is the municipality of Soto La Marina, where an anemometric was installed at latitude of 22 degrees 53 minutes 25 seconds north and longitude of 98 degrees 1 minute 37 seconds west. 10 minutes means of wind speeds, start and deviation, and duration were measured and recorded from the 1st of January until the 31st of December of 2006 at 20 and 40 meters high. The figures show the anemometric mast location and the global atlas with the most prominent geographical areas for the wind generation in Mexico. To obtain the wind speed characteristic, initially with the statistical analysis, the expected speed in the region equivalent to 5.7 meters per second is selected. Then a variable probability density function is adjusted, getting the modes are the wind speed located between the 5 and 6 meters per second. These central values of the probabilistic distribution are used to define the most common wind speed in the location. Therefore, the associated variability effects are used to test the converter efficacy under this wind variability. The wind rows present the complementary information where it is observed that wind speed comes mainly between south and southeast durations. The turbulence intensity means values range between 10 and 18%. The wind speed dispersion is decreased as the magnitude of the wind velocity is increased. Then, the turbulence intensity is selected from the most common wind speed, which is 10%. With this condition, the reactor works based on the Type 4 wind turbine is tested under typical wind speed dispersion condition for the region of Soto La Marina. These parameters are represented in OPAL-RT through MATLAB Simulink with the model wind developed by RISO National Laboratory based on Gaimal spectra. One way to generate a point of common coupling between the TRIA and AC grid is the WEX implementation, which can be formed by different types of wind turbines. The variable speed type 3 or type 4 are currently marked. Here, the modeling of the type 4 wind turbine is present thanks to its characteristics such as great power transfer capacity and total isolation of the AC grid, because it is interconnect through a power electronic converters. The main objective is that the end units of wind turbines remains connected under the presence of energy quality adverse phenomenon, for example, higher THD of current as a consequence of wind fluctuation variability. The Type 4 wind turbine AIMS is the machine angular frequency regulation, for which it is established that the wind turbine angular speed and PMSG rotor angular speed are equal. Then, the PMSG nominal power is determined by the wind turbine nominal power through the mechanical torque. Subsequently, using a plan model is represented the variable speed control, where the dynamic characteristic depends on the wind turbine viscous damping and the inertial constant. The wind turbine is represented in OPAL-RT through MATLAB Simulink by the wind turbine model and the three-phase permanent magnet synchronous machine. Subsequently, four wind turbines are included for the TRIA representation. The transfer power from wind turbine PMSG through the electrical torque is calculated considering that the wind turbine rotor has a cylindrical geometry, generating a closed-loop current control in the converter in rectify mode. The plant model depends on the stator phase resistance and the armature inductance of the PMSG. The converter in rectifier mode is represented in Opolarity through MATLAB Simulink by universal bridge in average mode. It should be mentioned that this can also be in a switching model where the switching frequency should be 10 times higher than the AC grid frequency. Next, H wind turbine is connected with one converter in rectifier mode. This link voltage regulation requires that be at least 1.1 times greater than the line-to-line voltage on the AC grid. The control is calculated through the stored energy in the capacitor, generating an active power transfer. The voltage control depends on the converter in inverter mode or grid side converter. Then, the plant model control is based on the capacitor value and parasitic resistance. The DC link control is represented in Opolarity through MATLAB Simulink by its respective equation. The DC side of each converter in rectifier mode is connected in parallel to the DC link. The GSC transfers the generated power between the wind turbine and AC grid, where the plant model is obtained from the RL filter that connects the converter into the AC grid. The GSC is represented in Opolarity through MATLAB Simulink by universal bridge in a switching model. In this research, this is formed by four voltage source converters connected in parallel. These are controlled by a digital sinusoidal pulse width modulation technique. The THD reduction is achieved by modifying the DSPWM switching signal in each converter connected in parallel. This is carried out by applying a different phase shift angle in each current signal of each base AC. The modulated signal angle is not changed. The TREA simulation contains five Type 4 wind turbines, where each wind turbine supplies its respective MSC. Subsequently, the DC side of each converter is connected in parallel to the DC link. The DC link is regulated by the GSC, which is formed by the parallel connection of four BSC and supplied by infinite bus. Each MSC is designed to keep a power of 2 MV and 2.3 kV volt. The GSC is designed to keep a total power of 10 MV, therefore each BSC connected in parallel supplies a power of 2.5 MV and voltage of 2.3 kV. Finally, a transformer integrates into the distribution system of 23 kV. The Opolarity technology module OP5600 is the main element in the WEX real-time validations, since this uses the model-in-the-loop concept, which allows testing of the control loop without the need for any programming code. The SM master contains most of the subsystems described above, as can be seen in the figure, using a sample time of 10 microseconds and consequently a switching frequency of 2 kHz. It is worth mentioning that the response results are obtained by the block written to file in MATLAB Simulink interface. This allows plotting the variables in MATLAB windows in order to have a better representation. The ESC console contains user interface blocks, that is, the monitoring of active and reactive power and the THD generated by the WEX. In addition, two subsystems are displayed, the wind fluctuation models and the DSPWM current signal of each BSC connected in parallel, corresponding to the GSC. These subsystems are integrated into the console because the user came to have the option of changing in real time the wind speed or the phase shift between the carriers, generating a different THD. This phase shift is shown in the triangular signal displayed in the figure. simulation results present the wind fluctuation speed from the Tamaulipas, Mexico, applied to the wax. Second, the five mechanical and electrical torques are shown, where the angular velocity control is made every 4 seconds. This means that the mechanical torques are followed by the corresponding electrical torque of each wind turbine. Thus, figure C shows that the diesel remains constant in the presence of the initial operation of each wind turbine. The next figure shows the GSC current injection or absorption into the AC grid, where one BSC handles a portion of the total power. Finally, the next figure shows the THD of the wax, where it is important to visualize the THD mitigation due to the phase shift into the modulation signals. In this research, are obtained advantages such as less total harmonic distortions, which results in a higher power quality, greater efficiency, ability to transfer energy with the minimal of power losses, low voltage stress on devices, minimize the filter working conditions, weight reduction and the power electronic device, filter cost reduction. In addition, through the Opal RT, it is possible mainly the validation system in real time or offline, reduce the compilation time of the DRIA, and increment the number of the wind turbines. Well, once the wax has been validated, the next step is the implementation of a three-phase BSC in an experimental prototype laboratory, for which it is used the power module 6 MOSFET converters. The experimental test bench contains an AC programmable source, resistive load, inductors, electrolytic capacitors, additional instrumentation elements, and sensors. This video shows the first step carried out by the master students, generated the switching signals of the converter by the OpalRT and the RT events library. Well done, guys! The current project is created by many topics which have been investigated by the IERUNAM Wind Group in different theses. These projects include areas such as forecasting of the wind speed in different areas of Mexico, wind fluctuation emulator for different types of wind turbine, the designed simulation and implementation of all required power electronic converters, depending on the type of wind turbine, and the wax validation at different power levels of the electrical network. It is important to mention that the OpalRT device is used to the simulation of the electrical network and the many wind turbines integrations. In the conclusions has been present the DRIA basin of WEC integration in the municipality of Sotola Marina, Tamaulipas, Mexico, of 10 megavolt amperes of power through a power electronic converter formed by 5 machine size converter and 4 grid size converter, generating a THD mitigation up to 4 times. Due to that, the phase shift of 19 degrees applied to the DSPWM in each BSC. The results has been supported by a complete mathematical model and the real-time validation and MATLAB Simulink and OpalRT technologies. Well, that's all for me. Thank you very much for your attention. If you have a question, please let me know. And my email is nasae@ier.unam.mx.